bomb ass t-shirts that say work like you have a million fans even if you only have one. Snap for that, that's kind of bullcrap. And them Jones are only $15. Yeah, that's right. That means you can afford it, right? Cool. All right, let me stop talking shit again. Lord, I don't wanna cry no more. Lord, I don't wanna cry no more. So please give me my wings to soar. Cause I don't wanna cry. I just wanna look to the skies. God bless you for taking that boy turned scam as your lawfully wedded oppressor. Though you had yet to make the connection, that ring was your chain, shackle, and muzzle, all in compact form, because we are all for convenience. Maybe you should have taken the hint when the preacher announced you man and his strife. But it didn't take long for you to realize that Mr. Wright was just a last name that spoke nothing of his character. Maybe he just showed drawn lips on his hands, since that seemed to be the way he kissed you. Bruises substituted for your passion marks. Pleads for forgiveness counted as your moans and physical put-downs acted as intercourse. You let him introduce his own copy of the Kama Sutra. And he must have been hitting all the right spots, because you cut him with him afterwards like he was the best you ever had. But it made no sense. Looking from the outside in, it appeared as though she was taking masochism to an outworldly level. Maybe she'd introduce her own copy of the dictionary. Although she was never a master of tall tales, she was able to convince herself that she loved him. Maybe she just redefined what love meant in her mind, or maybe she never knew the proper definition in the first place. Either way, she stayed, taking cheap shots on the chin, into the head, and on her back. That back with broad shoulders that carried a lifetime of corrupted interpretations on how life should be, that made Atlas cherish what he carried. That back was not made to be broken. So she turned into all of his flaws, but even though her back was strong, her spirit was not. But being the master welder he was able to piece her back together before shattering her interior all over again. You were supposed to have her back, and you didn't. He was supposed to have your back, and he didn't. He was supposed to have her back, and he didn't. Then again, he kind of did. He had her back, packed with ammunition, because he was starting a war, but this pet no didn't realize that she was the target, and he had her back, pedaling, because no matter how far she flew, she just boomeranged into his arms, and he had her back against the wall, because he laced her mind with the poison so vile that living without him and living without the vaccine, aka a slow and painful death. He wanted to be her only motivation for living, and she wanted him to be her motivation for leaving, but this seesaw was built on the principle of weight distribution, so he made sure she lacked the proper love and nutrients to make any gains, so her feet never touched the ground. And his inconsistencies attributed to his perfect attendance record, because this meant that he could possibly change, but her hopes were never high when it came to that heads or tails time. On Monday, he was a monk. Tuesday, a tyrant. The wicked treachery of Wednesday and Thursday came before the forgiveness of Friday, which was accompanied by the satisfactory sorrows of Saturday, and on Sunday, they prayed. Him for the strength to overcome his demons. Her, for the strength to overcome this demon. Great minds think alike, but neither had the mental capacity to think of how to reach that mountain peak for which their victory flags were planted. You were supposed to treat her as an equal, yet you treated her like property and let her know she can never leave, because possession is 9/10 of the law, and your perception was 9/10 of her flaws, so even if she escaped, she'd never be secure. And she knew this. It was as though her body had given up, but her mind continuously thought of exit strategies. You remember when you tried suicide? The barrel of that gun gave you the gentlest kiss you felt in years, but y'all never got past first base. It just wanted to show you fireworks, but you were so used to dark days that you didn't think you was fit to see the light. So now she tries Russian roulette, because there's a hope that a 1 out of 6 shot will increase her chances of tickling the tool's throat until it coughs out that thing restricting its breath, but she can't comprehend why her mind and body can't agree on him. Was she happy? Did she have anything to live for? No. Did she want to live? No. Did she love him? No. Click. Did she love him? No. Click. Did she love him? No. Bang. Forgive her, Father, but she has seen it. Although she was finally able to speak her own truth, she took her life in her own hands as opposed to putting it in yours, but his hands can't violently caress her anymore. She couldn't see any other way, cause Lord, she didn't wanna cry no more. She didn't wanna cry. So please give her her wings to soar. She don't wanna cry. She just wanna look to the sky and soar.